This is PTN News with your host, Scott Price. Thanks, guys. I'm Scott Price. This is on PTN News. Here's your top stories for today or this week. As we go to air tonight, passengers at Sydney Airport have been hit with a second day of flight cancellations and delays due to gusty winds. More than 30 flights to and from Sydney have been cancelled on Saturday, coinciding with the first day of school holidays in New South Wales. Sydney Airport said that they had been advised that air traffic will be likely be restricted to a single one way as a safety measure later this morning. More than 100 flights were cancelled yesterday due to strong crosswinds, with further winds forecast for later today. Sydney Airport said in a statement that a single one-way operations will be likely in place by late morning. As a result, there are some flight delays and cancellations, the statement said. The airlines are working hard to accommodate passengers and get them on their way. Cool. Now, over to wash them out. Yeah. Over to wash them out and the Ukraine war. When Juve Pessanzanza challenged his leader and former friend, he fractured the hard edge on Vladimir Putin's power. Now, with Russian president having threatened the Wagner boss and notorious warlord with criminal charges, he's attempting to seal up the crack. But what has been broken can really be whole again. The mutiny was an unprecedented challenge to Putin's authority and the first sign of those around him could be willing to turn on the Russian president. The revolt provided a lying and unfolding example of what could happen when someone demands something of the supreme commander-in-chief. Ukraine, now entering its 17th month of defending its territory, what has just invaded fought among themselves. As the war goes on, and the traitor pitches in, is allowed to live on, in exile. But questions must be asked. Is the chaos Vladimir Putin has created closing in on him? Putin will eventually fall. Now, over to France now. French police have started quelling protesters from the iconic central Paris Square, a place like the Concorde, after an impromptu demonstrator started amid nationwide unrest following the fatal shooting of a teenager by police. France Interior Minister Gerard Damain said 45,000 police and German armed officers will be deployed throughout the country on Friday evening local time, as the country braces for more violence on the streets. He asked the local authorities to halt buses and tram traffic, warning the firefighters and police officers that the next hours will be decisive, and know that you can count on your force efforts. public transport has been among the targets of the last three nights of unrest. Videos shared on social media showed a tram on fire in Lyon, and a dozen buses destroyed at a depot in northern Paris. Protesters have also torched cars, barricaded streets, and hurled stones at police. Okay, cool, alright, so on to now the PTN sports mail, Sydney and Geelong have actually had a full in draw at BSCG last night, and there you go, yep. Well, in the Ashes series, Australia lead by 121 actually lead the series 1-0. They're actually now 130 for 2 wickets, and England are at stumps at 325 ones. In the group stages of the T20 Blast 2020 cricket. Middlesex have actually won by 2 wickets with 2 balls left in play. While Hampshire beat Graham Morgan by 21 ones under the Duckworth. So the Duckworth Lewis Stern method. The target was around about 76. Cool. Let's have a look at the PTN. So the weather forecast now, to say the least. Alright, so the national weather forecast. So Melbourne, few showers and 14 degrees. Hobart, cloudy and 11 degrees. Canberra, 13 degrees and cooling. Sydney, also cooling at 9 degrees. Brisbane, 29 degrees and partly cloudy and cooling. Adelaide, few showers and cooling at 15 degrees. Darwin, smoggy at 31 degrees. And then Perth, fine and cool at 8 degrees. And that was your weekly edition or 10-minute edition of PTN News. Stay safe, everyone. And I am Scott Pice from PTN News. Good night. Good night. Good night. Good night.